me stumping on the enemy. God was stepping into me. Go ahead, get the water. Haters still shooting, they ain't know that I'm a baller. Eating God's flesh, boy, you know that I'm a marlin. On that main line, I'm a dedicated caller. Boy, I been dead, left the body on the altar. So I don't really see another way that I can fall.
All my problems sit around every corner. Temptations in my ear, and it just makes it harder. But you could never take my love for the Father. No, you could never take my love for the Father. So good, I just wanna go dash. Yeah, one step, two step, and it really got to be nothing. Dash. Yeah, yeah, grab a lady, your mama, your man. Yo, skip my partners, God.
To an assignment right now in the name of Jesus, for you did not give us the spirit of fear, but love, power, and a sound mind. So I bind the spirit of fear, and I bind the spirit of anger, and I bind the spirit of confusion right now in the name of Jesus. I rebuke every demon, every witch, every devil, every spirit that is not like God in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for everything, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we give our hearts to you. We give our lives to you. We lift up our hands to you. We give everything to you, O God, because you are our everything, O God. All we need is you. In the name of Jesus, you are our only King, O God. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we love you, O God. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, just bless the people, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, because by your stripes, anybody who is hurt, they are now healed in the name of Jesus. And people need you in their lives, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Jesus, in Jesus' name, amen.
Come on and give God praise, everybody. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Lord.
Yeah. here, Abba. We invite you here, Abba. Come on, let it out today. You are worthy, God. You shall receive all glory. So we surrender, God, right here. In your presence, overtake our life, our hearts belong to you. So we say yes. We surrender. Come on, is there anybody here that surrenders today? So we say yes. Lord, we surrender. I dare you to give them your yes today. We say yes. We surrender. We say yes. Oh, we surrender. Come on, let the music just minister to you for a moment. Let God speak to your heart. Father, reveal the things we need to surrender right now. Reveal the things that you want us to surrender to you.
St. Luke, the sixth chapter, and it reads, and it came to pass also on another Sabbath that he entered into the synagogue and taught. And there was a man whose right hand was withered. And as the scribes and Pharisees watched him, whether he would heal on the Sabbath day, that they might find an accusation against him. But he knew their thoughts. And he said to the man which had the withered hand, rise up and stand forth in the midst. And he arose and stood forth. Then said Jesus unto him, I will ask you one thing. Is it lawful on the Sabbath day to do good or to do evil? To save life or to destroy it? And looking round about upon them all, he said unto the man, stretch forth thy hand. And he did so. And his hand was restored whole as the other. Amen. If I could, I just want to focus in on that 10th verse. All right. On that 10th verse. And he said, as he checks out everybody within the room, after looking at everybody that was in the synagogue, the writer St. Luke declares that he makes a decision to focus on one individual. And after focusing on that one individual, he gives that one individual a command. And the command was very simple, to stretch forth thy hand. And the scripture says, And he did so. Y'all missed that. I'm gonna say that one more time. He checks out everybody that was in the place and in the space. And after looking at everybody that was in the place and in the space, the writer declares he focuses in on one individual. And to that one individual, he gives a command for that individual. And that command was simply to stretch forth thy hand. And scripture says, and he did so. I'm going to repeat that one more time. He checks out everybody that was within his ability to see. And after looking at everybody that was in his ability to see, he focuses in on one individual. And after focusing on that one individual, he gives that one individual a command or an instruction. And that command or instruction was to simply stretch forth thy hand. And scripture says, and he did so. So, I'm going to use for a subject what I'm going to work with today. What I'm going to work with today is, my subject for today is, I am the one. I am the one. Truly, saints of God, all of you who are a part of the household of faith, indeed because of his death, burial, and resurrection, and we are heirs and joint heirs, and there are many things that I've learned within the last, how long I've been in the church, over 20, 30 years, that I've been a born-again believer. There are many things that I've learned. There are many things that I've learned over the last 15 or so years where I became full-time in the ministry, whether it be singing or preaching. There are many things that I've learned. And there are many things that I've learned over the past year or so when I became the youth pastor here at CT. And there are many things that I've learned. But one thing that I've learned that the most difficult thing about being a child of the King, one of the most difficult things about being a child of the King is simply cultivating the ability to see what you don't see. I've learned one thing that's the most difficult thing as being a believer, just being able to literally cultivate the things that you don't see. Being able to, in other words, to expand your faith literally beyond your personal God. I'm not going to leave here until I get exactly what I came here for. Now, there's no need of me having to fight with my alarm clock to get out of bed and then I get here to the house of God and allow myself to be as distracted by an individual that does not have the same need that I have. It doesn't make sense that I work all week long, 8 hours a day or 10 hours a day, and having to deal with every type of heathen on my job, and then have to come to the house of God and have to sit next to somebody that's going to dictate how God is going to flow and function in my life. I made up in my mind that when I walk through those doors, that my mentality and my mindset is that I'm not coming to touch anybody but him. Even though the preacher may tell me to tap my neighbor, I may tap my neighbor. Even though he may tell me right now to give him an elbow, I may give him an elbow. If he tells me to give him a dap, I may give him a dap. But the reality is that I understand that's not the touch that I really came here for. So my mentality should be, I'm not leaving here until I get what I came here for. And that's solely the focus on experiencing God and receiving the breakthrough that I desire from him. Now, however, that could be easier said than done. You know, that could be easier said than done, because sometimes people want to dictate when and to whom God should move, and then therein lies the problem. The problem is that, you know, some people think, you know, that church is like the job, and because they've been at the church for so long, and because they have some type of tenure, they call it, and because they have the tenure, they want to explain how it is that God is going to function in my life. But but if you spend any time in the Bible like I did, you will note and notice that God always performed differently in each individual's life. Let me prove that to you, Kerrick. Yes, I will. Because there was a time when he told a man to go dip down in the dirty river, and then there was a time when he spit on the ground and he made clay and put it on somebody's eyes, and there was another time when he spit in somebody's face, but there was another time when he told this person that as they go that they would be healed, and there was another time he didn't even tell this particular person how they were going to be healed. All they did was sneak up behind him and touch the hem of his garment. I know you're saying, what are you trying to say, preacher? I'm trying to tell you that stop listening to people who are trying to tell you how it is that God is going to work in your life. But your mentality is, when you walk through the building and any way you bless me, Lord, I'll be satisfied. Y'all gonna pray with me this morning. Hallelujah. And that's why in this season of your life, you're going to have to go through it by yourself sometimes. Next thing you know, we'll be about in 2021. I wish that more members in this day and time was like this man in that day and time. Because as soon as somebody see your struggle, as soon as somebody see your challenge, as soon as somebody see your issue, the first thing you want to do, you want to stay at home, you want to have a pity party, you want to put on that old tacky robe, you want to put on that old sweatpants, and then you want to have the audacity to get mad because ain't nobody called and checked on you and see where you was at. The truth of the matter is that you're in the wrong place and in the wrong space. This man didn't care how people saw him, or he didn't care what type of issue he had. He didn't care what his struggle was. He didn't try to hide it. All he knew was, with my messed up self, I'm still going to come to the house of the Lord. And I wish that we would have people more like him to come to the house of the Lord and still bless God. Look at somebody and tell them, don't you stop coming to church. Come on, tell your neighbor, don't you stop coming to church. Hallelujah. So what you done messed up? So what, you done had a baby out of wedlock? Don't you stop coming to church. As a matter of fact, there was a whole lot of people who had babies out of wedlock. Don't you stop coming to church. Hallelujah. So you may still try to be going, sneaking and going out every now and then. And you're a little bit delivered. You're not all the way delivered. But if you keep coming to church, it may be wrong now, but everything will be made right. Because if you keep coming to the house of God, you might have an affliction right now. But after a while, you're going to run into Jesus, and he's going to turn that thing around. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, don't you stop coming to church. Hallelujah. So what, you done made a mistake? Don't you stop coming to church. So what, you done fell short? Don't you stop coming to church. So what, they saw you do it? And if they saw you do it, they're probably in the same place doing the same thing. Don't you stop coming to church. Hallelujah. So. Let me calm down here.
Stepping in with no fear, though. See, I know I'm supposed to be here, bro. Keep that music dope, drop it off your earlobe. It's way too precious, never waste my time. Never catch me slipping, always on my grind. Never catch me drifting, keep it focused mind. Trying to change the world, one day at a time.
Heart beating fast, I'm trying to make it through. Back on the wall, don't know what to do. I'ma make it through, I'm motivated. Trying to outthink myself. Round of applause, I like to thank myself. I'm always keeping it real with every word I.
Pastor Henry J. Bradley Jr. and the New Community Temple Church family are praying for the sick and shut in. Bill and Jane Simpson, Patrick McRae Jr., Sister Nikosha Friends, Sister Shirley Cobb, Kalia Bishop, Deacon Tommy and Deborah Jackson, Deacon Emma Braggs, Brother Damon Osborne, Brother Raymond Osborne, Mother Cora Jones, Mother Mildred Washington, your pastor, and the Community Temple Church family is praying for you. Sister Latanya Robinson, Sister Drew Jones, Sister Marty L. Davidson, Mother Lily Coffey, Mother Lynn Woodham, Mother Betty Harris, Mother Brenda Jackson, Minister Ann Montgomery, Mother Linda Lloyd, Sister Kim McRae, and Sister Lita Colby. No doubt, the pastor, your pastor, is praying for you.
Time of Praise with Superintendent Henry J. Bradley Jr., Saturday at 1 p.m., Sunday morning worship at 11:15 a.m., and midweek Bible study Wednesday at 6 p.m. A church in the community, for the community, showing the love of God to the community. Superintendent Henry J. Bradley Jr., Senior Pastor, and Elect Lady Alice Bradley.